Toastmasters. Have a look at the title.
What a fine.
It makes you feel hungry, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Let me assure you, this is not about food, or the fact that you might be hungry at the end of it. Before I start this presentation, I want to share with you the fact that these slides are designed as per the school of thought of icon-based presentation. Very simple, very abstract, and you can only see black and white in this presentation. It's a new school of thought. It's being very, very more popular now by many, many companies. So, two lessons in one. One in PowerPoint and one in evaluation. Let's start. The first thing you hear whenever you go to a Toastmasters meeting and ask about evaluation, you hear the same example. Evaluate like a sandwich. Evaluate like a sandwich. What is the sandwich? What is the classic sandwich? Very easy. Tell him what went well and be very motivated, very powerful in your motivation. Tell him what went well. Squeeze something in the middle, what needs improvement, and go back and tell him everything went well. What is wrong with this?
You might win, but you not value added.
Exactly, too much bread. There are two things actually wrong with this technique. Two things. First one is this. What we call whitewashing. Raise your hand if you are a whitewasher. Nobody is a whitewasher? This is a very tough club. Whitewashing is where you take your member, put him in the middle, and you paint him back and forth with white brush. There are some excellent whitewashers in Toastmasters. I know a person who is an excellent whitewasher. He would take any speaker and tell him, tomorrow you will be the world champion. You may call him Jumbazi, but yes, there are. Some people like that style, like whitewashing. We hate public critique. We like whitewashing. This is the first problem with the classic sandwich. The second problem, what can you see in this picture?
Beautiful lady.
Of course, beautiful lady, yes.
Mirror.
Something else.
Mirror.
Why did I put this on the slide?
They reflect their sides.
That's what happens, actually. We forget that we are evaluators, and we become speakers. We want to polish our image, so we forget about the speech. We want to create a new speech. We want to win the competition. We want to become the best evaluators in the world. And we forget about the speaker. Is this good or bad?
Depends on the situation.
See, this is the word spoken by a contest evaluator. Usually, you don't want to reflect yourself. You want to put all the attention on the speaker. It's his time to shine, and you're only there to help him shine. So I'm proposing something else. I'm proposing new roles and new shoes. Why did I choose? First of all, what do you think this guy does?
Mine.
Exactly. Why did you say he's a miner?
He's a builder.
That's right. Very easy. How about this guy? Nice. Something else. Not an accountant.
Editor.
Close to it.
Press.
Close to it, yes.
Journalist.
Journalist, close to it. No, you're far away.
Reporter.
Very close to it.
Journalist.
He's a newscaster. Goes on TV, evening or morning, and say, ladies and gentlemen, there is the brief for tonight's news, right? So one is a newscaster and one is a miner. Why did I put this on a slide about evaluation? Because you need to learn how to put yourself in these shoes. Become a miner and become a newscaster. How? Take the same sandwich and modify the layers of the sandwich. The first layer is I need you to become a newscaster at the beginning of the evaluation. All you do is become a newscaster at the beginning of the evaluation. Why is that? The problem with beginning of evaluation is we tend to repeat the whole speech. Toastmaster Mahmoud began by saying this. Then he said that. Then he moved into this. Then he ended with that. We repeat the whole speech and we waste up to a minute and a half. Guess what? We heard the speech. Why do you repeat the speech? You know? So I want you to become a newscaster. Give me the highlights of the speech in three sentences or three phrases, that's all. You pick, cherry pick, where were the highlights and say them. No repetition, no retelling of the story. Next, put on your helmet and dig deep into the core of your evaluation. We don't want general list. Your body language was good, your eye contact was good. Gold, the ore of gold, is found in the bottom of earth, not the surface, right? So effective evaluators are gold diggers. They are miners, they dig deep. They go inside the core of the speech. And the more you go inside, the dirtier it gets, because you dig below the surface and bring out what are the real reasons where you can help a person become better. And last but not least, because you run out of time, you close badly. Thank you, and you leave. You need to close your evaluation in the best possible manner. It's just like any human interaction. If you don't close it properly, you will leave a gap. And it's your role, your responsibility to close effectively by informing the person what's next. This is my modified sandwich. Let me tell you more about it. The first deep dive, I'm going to focus on deep diving, becoming a miner, a person who deep dives into evaluation. The first one is, you have to remember, the two main areas of evaluation are very simple. It's content and it's delivery. Everything about evaluation is centered around content and speaker. When you evaluate content, you evaluate the history. Because the speaker prepared already his material, you prepared your slides, you prepared your stories, everything is in the past. When you evaluate the speaker, you evaluate the future. Let me explain again. When you focus on the content, there is a huge chance that the speaker will not repeat the speech again, once and for all. So if you focus on the content, you are evaluating something that was done in the past and will not be repeated. But when you evaluate the speaker, you will give him tips and techniques for the future. Because he will again use the same voice for the future. He will use the same style for the future. So remember, content evaluation is always easier than speaker evaluation. It is less personal, this is more personal. So if you want to become harsh, the process for you, become harsh, even you, Ali, you focus more on the content and less on the speaker. Because when you focus more on the content, the speaker is protected. This is my product, not me. So if you want to use this cutter, the knife, and cut the speech, I protect the speaker. Remember that, very important. So, first of all, I think the best way to dissect the material of the content is through a very simple model. In, out, process. What comes in, what comes out, what goes out, and the process. Usually, in the in process, the best speakers are those who can hook us into a speech. Hook us into a speech. Let me give you an example of Mohammed Al-Ghahtani, the world champion this year. What was the hook of his speech? If you saw the speech, he had a very powerful hook at the beginning of the speech. Exactly right. In the middle of Las Vegas, in a country that prohibits smoking, you come into a room of 500 people and you're about to light a cigarette. That's the hook. And you know, we are very good at creating hooks because we are told the hook is very important. But what happens next? We create the hook and we leave the interest to go down all the way. Right? Remember that if you want to go to a hook, keep the interest level high. Don't make it dip down slowly. Next, you go into the process, the core of your story, the core of your speech. And you know, Toastmasters, the best way to have a core is to have a story. The more powerful the story, the more powerful the core, the more powerful the process. And in the end, we use with him. What is with him?
What's in it for me?
What's in it for me? I am here for a purpose. Give me something I can take back. What's in it for me? With him. Is an action, call for action, a thought, an emotion, a feeling. I want to take something back home. Next, the speaker. Who is this guy?
Iron.
Albert Einstein. Why did I use Albert Einstein as an example of the speaker?
Because he was Catholic, he was young.
No, he's a very boring speaker, by the way. He's a very, very boring speaker. But he has a very famous equation. What is the equation?
E equals mc squared.
That is correct. E equals mc squared. E stands for?
Energy.
M stands for?
Mass. Body.
C stands for?
Speed
of light. That is 300,000 kilometers per second. So the same thing can be applied on your speaker. There are three very important elements in any speaker. Trust me, they are the most important. Number one is energy. When was the last time you feel impressed by a person with low energy? I'm about to die. Toastmasters. Good evening.
Good evening.
Tonight I'll talk about motivation.
Yeah, you remind me of someone.
Energy, guys, energy is a really, really important factor. Even if you have a bad material with good energy, you will create some inbox. Trust me. So when you want to evaluate the speaker and you want to be less personal, evaluate his or her energy. Is it high? Was it low? A perfect area to focus. Second one, the body or the mass. Where is most of the nonverbal is located? Most of the nonverbal, 60% of the nonverbal is in the hands. We don't know what to do with the hands. We leave them hanging, we hold them together like Kirasan, we open them, we don't know. And it's always the same. People have problems with their hands. So evaluate the hands. It becomes less personal, less aggressive. Because I'm not evaluating you, Erfan, I'm evaluating your hands. See? Make it less personal, more objective. Last one, speed. Trust me, it is a real problem in those problems. People are too fast. We cannot grasp. And when we become wiser and older, the hearing aid becomes less effective. So we can't hear. That's why slow talkers are more effective than fast talkers. Evaluate the speed, become less objective. See, the whole purpose is to make it less objective. Less personal, more objective. So remember that E equals MC squared when you evaluate your speaker. Close with impact. The last point I want to share with you is how you close your evaluation. You need to close by telling the speaker how you felt overall about the speech. Were you motivated? Were you happy at the end of the speech? Were you inspired? And remember that you need to tell the person what's next by saying, I recommend that you move on to the next speech. Close properly. Say that. Summarize. Tell the person what's next. Don't leave the evaluation hanging. Remember, in the end, you're giving your opinion. Your opinion. Tell him or her your next stage, your next step should be XYZ. And close properly. List of don'ts, and this is my last slide. Number one, we don't want deja vu. What is deja vu? French for?
The place.
Seen before. Deja vu.
Have seen before.
Seen before. We don't want to see the speech again. We don't want you to repeat the speech. Number two, don't give new speeches. I'll give an example. In any speech competition, contest, in evaluation, the speech was about management. The first evaluator talks about his childhood. I remember when I was young, I had this playground. Wasting time, wasting. You are not speaking, you are evaluating. Dive into evaluation. Don't give new speeches. Three, I love this. In Toastmasters, for the new members, we have a general list. Check, 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 check. Everywhere you go, you see this general list. Body language was okay. Eye contact was okay. Hand movement was okay. Eye contact, okay, okay, okay. However, next time, work on your hand movement, body language. Avoid the general list. People don't like general list, you know? And sometimes when we give the symptom, we diagnose the problem, we forget the medicine. So you tell me what's wrong with my style, tell me how to improve it. Don't leave me hanging. Can you imagine going to a doctor with a bad flu, and all he does is, you have a flu, get out. Where's the medicine? Give me the, how can I improve it? That is the core of evaluation. How can you improve it? Next, this is a classic mistake. You go into a new story, you tell your life story, you go into this and that, and you get lost. You yourself, you get lost in the evaluation. Time runs out, becomes red, and you go over time, and you end your evaluation. You get lost in translation. So you forget time, and you go into sudden death. Now, that was my last slide. You see, when the lion wakes up in the morning, he has to worry about where to eat.